How to replace the system board.
Caution. Observe all precautions when removing and replacing components. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, keyboard, wireless LAN module, hard disk drive, and base plate frame. Removal. Gently lift up on the locking bar on the smart card reader board's IF connector on the system board, and remove the smart card reader board ribbon cable. Important. Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Gently lift up on the locking bar on the fingerprint reader ZIF connector on the system board, and remove the fingerprint reader ribbon cable. Important. Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Close the display panel and turn the notebook upside down. Gently lift up on the locking bar on the ZIF connector on the VGA USB board and remove the VGA USB board FPC ribbon cable. Important. Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Gently lift up on the locking bar on the power button board ZIF connector on the system board and remove the power button board ribbon cable. Important. Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Disconnect 1 to 2 display panel cable connectors from the system board. Note, touchscreen models use display panel cables with 2 connectors. Non-touch use only 1 connector. For easier removal of the system board, lift the wireless antenna cables out of their routing hook on the speaker assembly. Disconnect the speaker cable from the system board. Loosen the 2 captive P1 Phillips head screws that secure the fan to the top cover. Remove the 2 5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the top cover. Very carefully lift the fan end of the system board and then slide and lift the external connectors of the system board out from their cutouts in the top cover. Remove the system board. Replacement. Note, before installing a new system board, remove all memory, wireless WAN module, if installed, M.2 SSD mini card, if installed, heatsink fan assembly, and VGA USB FPC ribbon cable from the old system board and install onto the new system board. While using care not to pinch and damage any cables under the system board, tow the external connectors into the cutouts in the top cover, and then lower the system board into place over alignment pins and screw holes. Replace the 2 5mm P1 Phillips head screws to secure the system board to the top cover. Tighten the 2 captive P1 Phillips head screws to secure the fan to the top cover. Connect the speaker cable to the system board. Tuck the wireless antenna cables into their routing hook on the speaker assembly. Connect 1 to 2 display panel cable connectors to the system board. Note, touchscreen models use display panel cables with 2 connectors. Non-touch use only 1 connector. Insert the power button board ribbon cable into the power button board ZIF connector on the system board and gently press down on the ZIF connector locking bar. Important. Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the VGA USB board FPC ribbon cable into the ZIF connector on the VGA USB board and gently press down on the ZIF connector locking bar. Important. Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Turn the notebook over and open the display panel. Insert the fingerprint reader ribbon cable into the ZIF connector on the system board and gently press down on the ZIF connector locking bar. Important. Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the smart card reader board ribbon cable into the ZIF connector on the system board, and gently press down on the ZIF connector locking bar. Important: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Continue the reassembly. Replace the base plate frame, hard disk drive, wireless LAN module, keyboard, battery, and base enclosure.